Today, actually, I just noticed, represents day one anniversary since I was sworn in to Congress last January 6th. I've been working hard at a job that is much greater in magnitude and significance and importance than I ever imagined that it would be, but it is such a huge honor to be a member of the United States Congress that I'm honored to be there, and I'm honored to be here today with you as well. Now, as I said, I've only been in Congress for 1 year, so last year after winning the election, they asked me what committees did I want to serve on, and because of my background in business, I said, well, I'd like to serve on financial services. This was before the great economic crisis and the financial meltdown, so I didn't know what I was stepping into when I asked for that committee. And I also asked for the science committee, not because I know anything about science at all. So you might say, well, why is she here today? I was speaking with your executive director, Bob, a few minutes ago, and he says, you all are the geeks are us of the world today. And so I welcome you because you bring to the table the kinds of skills and innovation and creativity that I personally don't have. But at the same time, I think you recognize that what we do in Congress affects your ability to move forward and to bring to our country the kind of scientific innovation and the global competitiveness, the international cooperation that I know is part of your mission as well, that will bring us through the next century in the history of this great country. And so it's very important what you do, and I recognize how important it is, despite the fact that I have no scientific experience personally. I wanted to talk with you just a little bit about what I've been doing in Washington, beginning with committee work. As I said, I serve on science and technology, and that particular committee has been very instrumental in looking at issues that I think are important to you, and some of those include the jurisdiction that we have over NASA, over FAA's R&D programs, over the FAA's Office of Commercial Space Transportation, and the Office of Space Commercialization. That's quite a mouthful, but I think it encompasses quite a few things that are important, very much of importance to you all. I also serve on the Subcommittee for Space and Aeronautics, which is tasked with overseeing the health of the space industry and its highly skilled workforce. As was referred to earlier, this has become a cause for me in terms of trying to ensure, because Kennedy Space Center is in my district, and as I like to say, I live a few miles up the river from Kennedy Space Center, I have been working very, very hard to ensure that we mitigate the loss of our highly skilled and technical workforce there during the impending space gap that we all know is likely to occur at the end of the shuttle manifest. Over the past year in the committee, we've discussed a number of issues of importance to you all, including ensuring the safety of human spaceflight. We've had hearings on all of these, so we've had some of your members even testify before us. Strengthening NASA's technology development programs, enhancing the relevance of space to address our national needs, supporting commercial space, and increasing the biofuel R&D for civil aviation. We also heard testimony from Norm Augustine, who you know chaired the committee appointed by the president that was designated really to do a review of the space program and to provide us with some, and the administration with some alternatives or choices that we might make and some valuable information as the administration moves towards making the decision what is the next phase of space flight for our country. The Science Committee coming forward this next year plans to address many other key aerospace-related issues that are important to you and your members, including the oversight and possible legislation related to commercial space, which as you all know is a growing and valuable part of what we're doing in space exploration. The FAA reauthorization, which is currently pending in the Senate as we await the coming of the next-gen program to modernize the air traffic control system, military space issues, and also our continuing efforts in Congress to reform the ITAR so that we can increase our U.S. exports of aerospace technology and to help the American aerospace companies remain competitive in the global market. So this is a priority for us this coming year to try to reform those regulations so that you will have greater opportunities than you currently have. Another thing that's been very important to us as a Congress is the STEM education and the aerospace workforce. We talked a little bit about the aerospace workforce and the fear that we have of losing that workforce, particularly here in Central Florida, but as you know, NASA-related and manned space exploration-related activities take place across the country in nearly every state in America. So we're very concerned about the loss of the workforce, but we're also concerned about moving forward with STEM education and opportunities for people who are interested in science, technology, engineering, and math, and also providing opportunities that will increase the interest of those who are in school in those particular arenas. We are in a difficult situation in this country, as you probably know. I'm thankful to be here in a room of scientists and engineers and those who have a great understanding of those issues, but this country is actually not graduating a sufficient number of people involved in those arenas to do the kinds of things that we need to do in order to continue to be a leader and to be competitive in the global economy with regard to space exploration and everything related to science and technology. I know that, you know, as I said, I'm not a geek, and I'm still trying to figure out how radio works. I don't know, I don't get how you turn on the knob and the music comes from somewhere else, but then you add on top of that the television, the microwave, the GPS, all the kinds of innovations that have been discovered in the last 100 years, and you think ahead, and I know this is what you all do on an everyday basis, what will the next 100 years bring to this country, and how will it enter this world, and how will we educate the people who will have the kinds of ideas and the kinds of skills that you bring to the table so that we can be competitive and leaders in the community. I think there's no question that science is first and foremost in what will allow us to do that. And if we don't encourage it, I think it's at our own peril. We are actually educating scientists from around the world and then sending them back home and having difficulty hiring to fill positions here. So it's an issue of supreme importance, I think, as we go forward, and hopefully the administration and the leadership in Congress recognize this. Some of the ways that we're trying to do it are in conjunction with AIAA's President David Thomas. He testified before our committee, and they provided several recommendations to attract and retain the workers, such as loan forgiveness for engineering students and tax incentives for workforce development. These are issues that I would plan to pursue this coming year, my second year in Congress. And I will say this, that despite how crazy this year has been in Washington, and as you all know, it's been a huge agenda. We started the year with some things we didn't expect, including the economic crisis. We started the year being involved already in two wars. And the administration has taken on a number of agendas, which has caused this to be, according to my colleagues who have served in Congress for 10, 20, or 30 years, the busiest year ever in Congress. We move forward on a lot of fronts and things that are considered to be important to our future. One of those, among those, is the environment and the need for us to become energy independent and alternative energies. And these are things that weren't considered over the years in a way that they should have been. So we're looking forward to moving forward with that. And some of the things that we have passed this year will be very important to those initiatives, and it will require us to be graduating more people who are savvy, innovative, smart, and creative in the scientific endeavors. So we're looking to ways to incentivize that. And there are also other ways for improving STEM education, which would be to